Welcome back to Jesters of Ravenloft, where a group of comedians try to escape the horrors of the mists. With New Rogue fighting off death inside his mind, the rest of the troop awoke, bound, armorless, weaponless, and unable to use magic. Tyler and Dell speculated on why Dent and Arthur imprisoned them, but their questions were soon answered. Denton arrived wearing a Robocop armor, which infuriated Shadow Nemesis, and explained that he was frustrated at not being able to use the bodies in this realm to achieve his goals and that he realized he needed the bodies of Mistwalkers. Meanwhile, New Rogue had an epiphany that he must put aside childish notions and learn to rely on himself. Will what change escape with their bodies intact? I doubt it.
Hello, friends, and welcome back to Jesters of Ravenloft. We're here to record our second episode of the night. But before we do that, I will do a quick recap of what happened in episode one for anybody who is joining us a little bit later. And then Tyler will do a chat watch. Episode one, our heroes, after a massive showdown with all of the evil armies of the realm, had been rescued by Dent and Arthur, only to wake up and find themselves collared with anti-magic collars and strapped to armatures in a spooky science, but in a medieval sense, basement, where they discover that Dent and Arthur, who has claimed their items, their armor, everything from them, has been capturing them and is planning to use their body parts after the experience of building something else and failing with all the things in this realm. He had also left New Rogue to die, unhealed, though our heroes were healed. New Rogue he left to either demonstrate that gods don't care about people at all or that they are hypocrites and the only lives they will spare are their clerics. So New Rogue, trapped inside a foggy realm in his own mind because his body had stubbornly held on and refused to die, was chased through a vision from Ezra that showed him perhaps the next stages on his cleric's journey, with the way that he interpreted it, realizing that he had to rely on himself and maybe get out there and do some things, maybe some good, maybe some stuff that he might not consider good, but just to get out there and carry things forward. So he was fully healed in a miracle and became perhaps his own version of an adult. That's what occurred. Yeah, okay. All right, it's time for us to return to Ravenloft. New Rogue, you find yourself brought back to life with all your faculties and all your physicality. Your magic is present, but being limited by your collar, so you can't reach it the same way as everything else. You can feel, at this point, and perhaps for this brief moment, the eyes of your god upon you. Mm. Are there any physical changes to you with this internal growth after a miracle? Your hands and arms stay the same. I'm talking cosmetic more than anything else.
If only because I had the halo, circling my head, that thing was extremely hot. And as it dissipated, it kind of just like slightly singed across my forehead. Like,
So everything is the same, but you have a sunburn style.
Yeah, it's not a forever. It's not a forever thing. That's just like but I can't touch it. Am I locked up basically like
your hands are down. So you are in an armature. Down. So you are standing, but your hands are down. Your neck is pinned to the armature. So it's almost like a standing kind of like the way they would do the human body for any of the various gendered versions for a washroom or the non-binary version. It's just that pose.
I see. Okay. Out,
then at an angle, you are also trapped like that. Is there anything you say to your friends having come through this magical experience? Or that your friends say, seeing him come back to life and fully heal instantly for a brief, strangely holy moment?
New Rogue!
Oh my god, New Rogue, you're okay!
Yeah!
Release us, save us, New Rogue!
Sorry, there was a lot of talking. Who wants to go first? What was that?
You're back, you're healed, magically. Can you do more?
I don't know yet.
Denton's bad, and he trapped us, and he wants to cover us up. You have to save us. Please, please, please.
Denton Arthur?
Bad guy. Totally bad guy.
Bad. He killed Acer.
Acer?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, that's good, though. But, yes, we're locked up. I get it. Yeah. Sorry to bug you. Before you guys ask me questions, is Jack Magnum, is he okay?
We haven't
don't
seen
know where
anyone
is.
Yeah.
Or Dr. Deputy.
Or Rumpelfurskin.
Okay. I'm not sure if what I can do just yet. Can I analyze like my surroundings, because I see they're locked up. They're locked up in a similar fashion.
Yeah.
Okay. Do I still have like anything on me except, is it just loincloth?
Just underclothes. Yep, that's it. Just your loin thong.
Okay. And roughly how thick are these shackles? Like their
technology? They're about an inch thick. They're very, very sturdy.
Okay, so I feel I have a little bit more magical juice running through me than usual at this point. However, I do feel extremely limited, so I'm not entirely sure if what I can do would break it, but I'm going to attempt one spell that I haven't used before, and I'm hoping it can break past this shackle. Spiritual weapon. I fucking need you, pal. Oh, yeah. Come on, baby.
Ah! Can you roll me an arcana?
Okay. That is a 13.
You see his collar light up and flash, and New Rogue, that spell slot is used, but no spiritual weapon appears.
Oh, no.
Oh. Okay.
Oh, yeah, we can't use magic because of these colors that we're wearing.
Right. Sorry. No, I got that. I thought I was just a little more powerful. I didn't know, brink of death. Okay. No. Hysterical strength. Okay.
And that's when the mist begins to rise from between the stones, the uneven stones at your feet. And it gifts you, New Rogue, with 2 points of inspiration. You, Shadow Nemesis, with 1 point of inspiration.
Hey.
Del, you realize how close you are to death and losing your body, so you suffer 1 point of perspiration.
Yeah.
And Tyler, you realize how close you came to death with the Death Loop Watch and how menacing having another pain gone is for you in the future, and you suffer 2 points of perspiration.
Oh, jeez.
As the magical energy in this room rebalances. But that's when you all realize that there is a small portal growing in the corner of the room. And out of it steps a goat. And Jack Magnum appears through the portal and just says,
steps in. What?
What the hell?
And 3 heartbeats later, another tiny figure steps through that portal. And you hear a jangling of bells along with a magical stick as a tiny goblin comes out and goes,
what?
I'm the new bug. And the portal closes behind him. And he's like, ooh, you guys are tied up looking pretty cool. I brought this goat.
Hey, it's the Noblin.
That's not my name. It's the new bug.
Ooh.
Didn't he? Yeah. He just starts dancing. He just starts dancing around your stuff. Jack Magnum circles up to you, New Rogue, and just presses a head against your leg. Presses his head against your leg.
Oh, thanks, Belle. No, you feel soft. Okay, I'm softer.
I wish we could dance with you, but we're sort of indisposed.
Oh, yeah, you guys are tied up. You're going to get killed like cool people. Ooh.
Hey, Nilbog, you know what would be really cool instead of us just lying here and dying?
I don't know, getting taken down, and I think you're getting your brain out looking at the pictures. Ooh, that'd be pretty cool, brain on the outside.
Oh, no, that's so boring. That's so last year. Do you know what's really cool?
Oh, what? I want to be cool. I'm the Nilbug. I'm the coolest.
Oh, well, ooh. I mean, I don't know, guys. Should we tell him what the coolest thing is? I don't know if he's cool enough to know what the coolest thing is.
Tell us the cool thing, Nilbug.
All right, you guys want to know what the coolest thing is? It's you guys.
No, just it's me. I'm up
and do
the cool thing.
I'm the coolest, so I told him it's dying. Remember that time you guys stabbed me with a bunch of knives?
We remember you dying.
Yeah.
Can you all roll me a perception?
No.
That's you, New Rogue.
There's a goat. I'm sorry. It's very cute.
Well, it's not an 11. It's a 10.
17 for Tyler.
It was perception?
Yep.
That is a 10.
Me and Adam are at the same angle. We're just seeing the same stuff.
That's an eight.
Okay, so for three of you, this is just the scene that's happening. Tyler, it is unsettling for you as you realize, looking at the Nilbog, you're pretty sure this is a different goblin. Like, the outfit seems the same. All the accoutrement, the movement, the voice seems, like, very similar to the same. But there's just a couple of the scars are different. The nose is a slightly different shape. It just doesn't seem right.
And you're not the Nilbog.
Oh, I'm the Nilbog. Ooh.
You're not the Nilbog that we talk to. You're a different guy.
Oh, I'm the same Nilbog. Ooh.
You look different.
Yeah, that happens to all of us when we die. Ooh, different. Ooh,
what do you mean us? What do you think happens when we die?
If you're cool, then you die, and then you go out and get a new goblin. Ooh, and then you go ride that one around for a bit. I'm the Nilbog.
You're the Nilbog, and you drive goblins.
Yeah.
Ooh, we're in a different body.
You inhabit goblins.
That's why I can dance so good.
I think he means to say some sort of ethereal entity that can just possess goblins, right? And goblins specifically, or just anything, but you choose goblins.
Listen, I'm one of the gods of mischief. Ooh, one of the goblin gods. Ooh, yeah, you got to respect the Nilbog. I'm a god. Okay, you should all bow. You should all bow to me.
Yeah, I mean, I tilt my head down.
But
wait, why can't you?
We are trapped.
Yeah, no dancing, no bowing.
But if I let you out, you would dance and bow to me?
Oh, we are. Ooh, we're ready to do that.
Especially Jack Magnum. He loves dancing.
Mm-hmm.
That goes to dance.
We'll put on a real show. We'll put on a real show for you. We'll
all right, then.
There's somebody here and we can find them and put on a show for you and rip them in half for you. Would you like that?
All right. Which one of you guys is the coolest?
Me.
Okay. And he just starts climbing up to work on your neck collar.
Ooh.
Let's see what he can do. He rolls a two and it's like, oh no, this is way too hard. Sorry, I got nothing. You gotta get a key or something. And that's when a mist portal appears in the corner again. And it's a small portal. And a tiny figure runs through just saying, I'm here, Black Knight! I can save you! The Doctor Deputy appears.
What is
sent
God,
by the mist
what?
To assist.
Save me! Save me, Doctor Deputy! Save the Black Knight!
Okay, what do I do? It looks like you only got your underpants.
Yes, I do. But you have to get these collars off of us. These magic collars. On all of us.
Oh! Okay. I'll try Black Knight just a second. Hi, everybody! Just a second.
Hi. And he just starts climbing up Adam's body in the armature.
You're Shadow Nemesis, right? You better not be fucking Adam. Is he gone?
Oh, yeah, he's gone. Trust me. You do not want him back.
Yay! All right, let's get this collar off.
And he's going to try. He rolled a five, and he's like, I can't do this. It's too hard.
Hey, no. Hey, buddy.
What's up, Uncle Juice?
Oh, well, if you are helping us again, why don't you use that inner strength from within? Cast Guiding Bolt on the shackle.
Oh, yeah.
That's around his neck.
Not on my neck, though. No.
All right, just shut up, everybody. I'm going to try to do this.
And he turns around and he bends over, aiming his ass at your neck from your shoulder, Shadow Nemesis. And he says,
come on, death. Give me all the death.
And he rolls.
New Rogue, I'm going to come back as a ghost and I'm going to haunt you forever. And I'm never going to stop.
Ah, I'm too tired. I can't do it.
Okay, Dr. Deputy, you need to find keys. You need to find a key and unlock us.
Okay, where's the key
coming from?
Yeah, Dr. Deputy, where's everybody else?
I was by the tree, and then the mists kind of came up, and then I just felt a hand shove me, and now I'm here.
Who else is by the tree? Is everyone alive?
I mean, most of them. There's like all the bunch of the werefolk are still alive and stuff, and then, I mean, all the bad guys went gone, so like big lose there. That was too bad. You know, all the people you don't want to live always survive the battle, and then the people you do want to live all turn to goo.
Great. Hey,
well,
I have a question for Ryan, the dungeon master.
Sure.
Roughly, how big are the How much room is there between the bars at the top of the wooden door? Like, is it big
the
enough?
The Doctor Deputy could definitely fit through. The Nilbog could not.
Okay. And
the
Nilbog
is goblin size, so he's like 3 to 4, kind of 3.5 feet tall. Mm-hmm. The Doctor Deputy is under a foot tall. He's a doll.
Okay. And Jack Magnum somewhere in between?
Jack Magnum's, a small goat. So, you know, 2-ish feet tall. He's tiny. He's got a little bit of baby to him.
Okay. I'm wondering, what we could send them out, guys, to try and snatch some keys. Like, I would put Doctor... Actually, I don't know which one would be better.
Why don't you all go, since no one's making any headway with these collars or these manacles.
Ooh, I'll take the tiny murderer out into the distance. Yeah, and I'll bring the goat. Then we get a key and we can come back.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, you don't... You trust the Nilbog over Dr. Deputy? Oh, well, because he betrayed us. That makes sense. But I don't know. Maybe Jack Magnum should stick around here. I don't want him to get hurt, gang. So maybe.
And that's when the mist swirls up from below again, creating a much larger portal against the wall. And you hear the clattering steps of a bone horse as Rumpel Foreskin walks through, sent by the mist. And says, "Hey guys, how's it going?"
Seems like pretty good right here. I'm so glad you're not dead.
Oh. Hey, this okay, we got to get you guys free. Just a second. And Rumpel Foreskin's going to move over and lash out with a rear hoof and discover that Rumpel Foreskin's metal leg can smash open these manacles. So in a few short expert kicks, you are all freed as Dr. Deputy is very sad he does not get to go on a mission. But you are all now standing in your clothing. And you have a small coterie of NPCs with you.
And we have magic collars on still?
Everything's off. You are off the chain. You are free.
Okay. Yeah, I figured out how to break those after I wore the last one. Whatever's in this realm, this shit's fucked.
I hug Rumpel Foreskin.
Yeah, you kicked them off our throats real good.
Yeah, yeah, well, I kind of used a little string thing for that to unlock those. I kicked the armatures. It's fine. I didn't think we had to go into it, but like we could really walk through it if you want. I was kind of trying to storybook.
No, that's
it. It was amazing. It was
thank you so much, Rumpel Foreskin.
Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. So we're in some sort of weird underground thing?
Yeah. How'd you know?
Yeah, Denton. Denton is full on bad.
Yeah, Denton. It seems like he might have become the Dark Lord.
Mm.
Or always was. I don't know.
I don't know.
Oh, that makes sense. That makes sense. Well, I mean, the last time you guys killed the Dark Lord, then one of you just like became the Dark Lord, right?
Yeah.
Wait. But that took magic, right? That was like Ezra had to get involved.
Yes, I think so. Yes.
Mm. Yeah. So I mean. Unless Ezra also has Denton on like retainer or whatever. Denton's just been the Dark Lord.
Great. We're so good at
this. That's a bummer.
Oh, man. Like I had so many opportunities to eat that guy's brain and I just chose not to do it. Oh my God.
He was really nice. I mean, my hand and your leg.
Mm. Yeah. I mean, he did some nice stuff. That's true.
Nilbog, sorry. Nilbog, you seem to have control over some of these portals, correct? Because you're a god.
Oh no, I'm just the Nilbog. That's a different thing. I'm just here, man. Ooh, you guys promised that you'd dance and battle me now, so I think it's time to get dancing.
Well, that was if you could free us.
Well, I mean, I'm in charge of the portals then, so I definitely brought everybody here to save you. Time to dance a bow.
I'd rather this guy be a friend than a problem. So if you guys are good to dance
I'll just
Jesus
do
Christ.
Fast dance. Yes.
Okay. Yep.
Can you all roll me a performance?
Jesus Christ.
Oh, that's charisma. Can I use danger sense?
No, it's not a trap. You're just dancing.
Oh, okay.
All right. Well, I rolled with my buffer 23.
Whoa, nice.
Wow. Yeah. What's your buffer?
For a performance, it's a +5.
Oh, nice. Yep.
Wow. Yeah.
I got a 15.
With my performance, it is a total of 24.
Whoa.
These
nice.
Boys.
I got a 21.
All right, everybody. Remember that dance scene that we wrote that we never performed at the Edinburgh Festival?
Apparently, yeah. It seems like we do.
The one where we all did the worm on top of each other until we formed that pyramid? And then
we were just a gyrating worm pyramid on top of each other?
Yeah.
With Dance Bros Deluxe, that scene?
Yeah.
Dance Deluxe.
Yeah.
That sketch.
And then at the end, you got ridden by that prince, and you guys go about doing the dance, leading into the worm, leading into the pyramid, and Dr. Deputy, who also somehow rolled a 21, is just becomes, as you become this giant worm, just a prince of Arrakis, riding it through this invisible desert, as the Nilbog goes apeshit, just... You guys are so cool. Oh, this is the best dance ever. I wish you guys were goblins. I'd run around inside all you till you got killed. So cool. Yeah. He's psyched. You have fully won over the Nilbog.
Great.
Rumpelforeskin refused to take part and just stood aside.
I started doing the Macarena and then sort of gave up when the worm situation happened.
Yep. But it worked. The Nilbog.
Whatever you guys need. This is so cool. Oh, yeah.
Weapons? Do you have weapons?
Can you find our stuff?
Yeah, we need our stuff.
I mean, sure. If you can open that door, I'll go look around. I'm the Nilbog.
I'll try the door and see if it just opens.
It does.
Oh, I was about to Hulk out and punch it.
You have successfully escaped this room. As you make your way out, you're realizing that you are in almost a labyrinthine series of what you would guess, looking at the various rooms, of either storage or scientific rooms, experiment rooms, tech rooms. There's not a ton of stuff in a lot of the space, but you get the feeling that there may have been in the past, that he's being forced to cannibalize technology to create new technology as he works.
Oh.
You are seeing robots. In the distance, they seem damaged. They seem damaged from the combat, but you're realizing the moment you move outside of the immediate area, this place is being regularly patrolled. What do you do? What do you say? What do you
do? Are there some demolished robots nearby? Perchance?
Del, can you roll me an Arcana?
Sure. 18.
Nice. Del. You had contact with the various ghosts and souls of this area.
Yep.
And as you begin to move out, you realize that the ghosts may have been pointing you in a direction, the lateral kind of sideways direction underground. You see that there are a number of ghost souls or auras in that space that aren't moving.
Mm-hmm.
That may be a place that could help you with what you are seeking right now, knowing that escape was undoubtedly your path out and the ghost told you not to trust Denton and showed you this.
Yeah. I'm getting ghost vibes, I say, but I'm going to look around and wait, like, see if there's a moment to run towards that.
Great. So if you're trying to time that out and bring the group with you, if the four of you could roll me stealth.
Is that a danger sense because there's danger?
It's not a danger sense, but I will give you all advantage because the robots that are patrolling are damaged. So they're making more noise than they normally would, and their sensors are not as sharp as they might otherwise be.
Right. Nice. I'm sneaking on the ceiling, too. I'm doing like a little Spider-Man crawl on the ceiling.
Great.
Sorry. I don't have my Stone of Decent Luck, right? That was in my pouch.
You do not. That is gone.
All right. Okay. Good, because... No, I was hoping you'd say. All right, it's 17.
I got a dirty 20.
Nice.
He's just the knight.
I got a 9. Not helping the group very much.
I also got a 17.
Boys.
All right, you make your way forwards. Del, with you in the lead and everyone else sneaking alongside.
We're still doing the
You are leading the way around the corners because you're the only person who can guide the group, which you can't do effectively in a high-stress situation from the back.
Right.
And it all seems to be going well until, Del, you step around the corner and find yourself facing two damaged robots and both of them raise their flamethrowers.
Oh, shit.
We'll take a quick commercial break right there.
Oh.
Del, there is a brief moment of panic as you see the flames on the front of these flamethrowers ignite. And then a wave of tiny figures pours past you. You see the Nilbog, and you see Dr. Deputy, and you see Jack Magnum lunge at these robots. And Dr. Deputy reaches in behind a mask and just starts stabbing from under a chin through a gap in the armor, and that robot goes down. Sweet. And the Nilbog just opens his mouth really wide and goes, and inhales the front of the flamethrower, which starts pouring fire into his body, and he's just taking it. He's glowing red from the inside with flame and still jangling and dancing. And Rumple Foreskin flips around and kicks that robot's head off, and it falls dead to the ground.
Very convenient. Wow. Okay.
Thanks, everybody. Is the Nilbog just dead, or?
And the Nilbog turns around and coughs at a bunch of smoke and goes, "Ooh, that was pretty neat."
Wow.
Yeah, it was.
He's an immortal.
All right, everybody, grab a flamethrower. I want to take a flamethrower.
Okay, can you roll me? I'm going to say sleight of hand, and you will get an additional +2 because this would involve tinkering for you to try to remove a flamethrower.
Okay. Wait, what? Sorry? This is a sleight of hand. Okay, all right.
Sleight of hand, but add an additional +2.
All right, okay, all right. Okay, so that is a total of... I'm going to use inspiration. I'm going to use inspiration. Okay.
You also have perspiration, so roll me a d6.
It's a 1.
Oh.
All right. So you step forwards to try to do this. Can you, Nat, do you know what? I know how this will play out, but roll me with disadvantage because this is actually a real roll and it's affected by disadvantage. It's not a spooky success or failure. That's important.
Just roll this.
Roll another one and you're getting the worst number.
Yeah, you're taking the lower.
Pretty bad. All right. Can't take 19. So it's, what did I roll? It was a 9.
You manage to get the flame gun part of the flamethrower off the body, but you can't successfully keep the fuel attachment and the hose there. So it ends up getting severed and a bunch of fuel ends up on the ground. But there is a second robot if you want to attempt this again.
Yep.
Roll away, sir.
Yeah.
Roll me a sleight of hand. You get an additional +2.
Okay. Yeah. I'm just like, whoops. And I kind of, I kind of like slide
it around like, come on, man, hurry up.
I slide the broken gun over to everybody being like, that could be a club. Just hold on a second. Hold on. This could work. All right. And I'm going to.
Does anyone want to pick up the gasoline soaked club?
Yes. For the robot piece, I actually just for like defensive reasons, when fire was being shot inside of the robot, did I hear that? Or is it like,
the one robot was stabbed through the helmet by Dr. Deputy and mm-hmm. died. And the other, the Nilbog ate the flames and Rumple Foreskin kicked the head off.
The robot ate the flames, but flame wasn't permeating like the metal itself. Okay.
Flame was not involved in that part of the combat. The Nilbog just ate all the flames.
I understand. Okay. I'm just going to, a simple piece, not a weapon, but just maybe a piece of the metal just to use as kind of a potential shield.
Yeah, you could try to bust off the chest of it. So I'll get a strength roll from you. Is there anything, Del, you or Tyler would like to do with the robot corpse?
Are we in the place where the ghost told me to come to? Not yet.
No, just got ambushed by a patrol. You're close. You could be there in a minute, but
great. The only thing
your friends
I would
are currently
like,
looting in the hallway.
Yeah, I'll take a tiny piece of the robot, just a little bit.
Do you want to take like a finger or what are you trying to get?
I would
from
just
the robot?
Want a piece of shrapnel that's sharp if I need that, to use it.
I will say yes. You can just have that for free with all
Thank
the damage
you.
That's been going on. Tyler, Perfect. Is there anything you would like to do?
I need to see how long a spell lasts. 1 minute. Nope, not casting it now. I'm going to go on ahead to where we were trying to go.
You can't see where you're going, so you just have to wait for Dell. She's getting her
trick. It's not like a straight. Okay, got it.
No, there are a couple of different paths and rooms down here.
Then I'm waiting impatiently, just getting more and more stressed as my friends have fun with robot parts.
Adam, what did you roll?
I have not rolled yet. I am doing it now. All right, that is a total of 22.
22. Adam, you managed to remove the gun and the backpack with the hose connecting them. You are now carrying a flamethrower.
All right. Okay. I put the backpack on and my eyes like burn red as the flamethrower. And I'm like, time to get hot. And I go on the ceiling and I'm like, let's get hot. Let's go.
Repeats it.
In underwear.
New rope. And you, what did you get for your roll?
Yeah, I got a 15.
15. You do manage to pull the chest plate off of this robot. Again, these are humanoid, kind of 1950s sci-fi looking robots. There are a lot of hoses and cabling with some joints. As you pull the chest off, there is a wet squelch, and you are horrified to look inside the torso and realize that there are lungs, a heart, and a stomach.
The robots were people? Were they always people? Or is this a new thing?
Gross, gross, cool, but gross, gross.
Okay, let's get moving.
Oh yes, I was on a battlefield, and then Dr. Deputy just starts going off. They had parts in them. Like if you bust them open, there's human bits. That's why I knew you could stab it in the eye stalks and the brain, and then they got the lips and the tube and stuff for talking out.
Oh, stop! I'm gonna throw up.
Oh, good job, buddy.
I think Denton.
Oh, no problem.
I think Denton was turning all of the people in his artificer village into robots. Yep. I think we've all made that.
Yeah.
Made that,
I,
you know,
I'm put those things like together. It.
Yeah. I got that.
I don't okay. Like it.
Okay. He's a sick freak. Okay. Well, I got my shield.
And you've got your shield. So you all continue down the hallway and find yourselves inside what looks like a repair shop. You're seeing a number of different tables. You're seeing walls with designs and different schematics. You're seeing some programming language, which you guys would recognize, kind of the simple binary. But the wafer cards that you would see in really old computers seem to have been handcrafted by him for his robotic purposes here. But perhaps most interestingly, you're seeing a number of disassembled robots or heavily damaged robots, the Protectobots from in-town, that have been laid out on some tables. Del, you're realizing that the spirits you've seen are attached to the interior of these bots.
Oh, I feel that's awful.
You can see bolts have been out, that screws have been unscrewed. It'd be very easy to kind of take things apart or try to take a look at any of these robots. They also all were armed. And you can see that the armaments have been detached. So there are two rifles available in this room and two flamethrowers available in this room that appear to have been left behind for when these robots are repaired.
I'll walk over and grab a rifle.
As you grab a rifle, the robot on the table twitches and you just hear,
"We forgot that."
No. Oh, they're people. They're like ghost souls are stuck here.
You're hearing stuff?
I can tell that there's ghosts like attached to them.
God. Should we put them out of their misery?
Or can we commune with them and see if there's some way to turn them back?
They got a mouth tube if you open up the head.
Oh.
Okay, yeah, let's just do that.
Yeah, if the one
so you peel the robotic top of the head. The bolts had already been removed off of the head structure of the robot. And when you look inside, you see a human brain being held in place by a number of calipers, along with bare eyeballs at the end of the optic nerves, and just a tube showing up to the shape of a human mouth with some of the bone structure around it to maintain it. But it's all wet and glistening. When you look at it, you can see a number of electrodes are attached throughout. Your best guess at this point, I'm going to say, creepily enough, Shadow Nemesis, because a combination of your understanding of evil and Adam's understanding of tinkering would be that it seems like the organic matter here is being used as a battery to power the robot.
Oh. From what I can understand, it seems that the fleshy bits are using like a battery, say, to power the robot bits.
And the eyes turn and swivel and start staring at all the unit devices.
Kill me.
Okay, yeah.
He did this.
I'm so sorry.
Who were you? Who are you? Sorry.
My name was Miss Maggie. I was a matchmaker for monsters.
Oh.
We had so many types in this village. And then Denton. His wife died, and then things started coming out of the woods. We didn't know it was him until too late. We didn't know. His bots seemed so good. Anyone too badly injured, he said he would show them mercy, but they were just more bots. Just the bots.
Okay.
I'm sorry.
The thing that is perhaps most unsettling with this conversation, on top of all of the facts, is you can hear the internal mechanisms of the robot quietly saying, "We protect the town," every time the person inside speaks. Mm-hmm. And you realize every time a robot said to you, "We protect the town," the person inside was trying to tell you something.
Ooh, that's a spooky feeling. Okay. Well, rest in peace. And I grab the brain and rip it out.
Wait, hold on. No.
You do that. They are dead. You have a brain now.
All right, take a bite.
Wait, what?
All right. Next. What's this one, though?
Okay, just let's not do that again. We can ask if there's any, I don't know, like, way to take down Denton Arthur, if there's any secrets. One of them might know that. Right, like, maybe Maggie would have.
Oh, she was a matchmaker. She wouldn't have known. How about this one? Maybe this one was like, it's like, Buddy or something like that.
Okay. And Dr. Deputy takes the front of the helmet off and you see another nightmarish interior. This one different colored. So your guess, you haven't seen a lot of internal organs of various species. It would be originally a non-human, but so many beings in D&D are humanoid that you wouldn't know what. You just hear,
kill me.
We will, but first...
Come on.
I'm so sorry.
I'll do really? It.
First, tell us, okay. Do you know any way, some secret way of taking down Denton Arthur? Does he have any weaknesses, specific ones that we might be able to, take advantage of?
He lied. He lied to all of us and then turned me and my brother into this. I'm Scruffy McRuffles. And that's my brother over there, Ruffles McScruffy. Two different moms, same dad. That's right, the last name.
Yeah.
He liked it. Sounded sort of like him. Okay. It was a polyamorous marriage.
So you don't know how to take him down.
Let me roll just a
And any vulnerabilities whatsoever.
Anything. How many robots are in this workshop? For me to math out, like, how long are we going to be in here?
Yeah, there are four. And Scruffy McRuffles looks up and says, "I don't know, just stab him a bunch, I guess. Whatever."
Okay.
All right. Kill I rip me. Up the brain.
We protect the turd.
And the suit deactivates, and you've eaten that brain.
Yeah, and I got two kind of like in my, like I'm cradling in my arm. All right, next.
How many exits are in this room?
Yeah.
We'll take a quick commercial break right there. There are two exits to this room, one that you came from and one at the opposite end of the room. There are doors to this room. They are closed. The doors are fixed. So you're confident whatever sound is being made in this room is not going to be heard. You can also see in the hallways outside, there were a lot of kind of scratches in the stonework and other things. You get the sense that there were a lot of robots marching around here a lot of time, and you're not seeing any of that floor damage in this room specifically. Your guess would be, with it being a workspace, they get brought in, put together, walk out, but it isn't dealing with the same level of security. This feels like a relatively short-term safe space within what's going on here.
Okay.
I will say, knowing that this brain pattern is ongoing, you meet two more horrifying brain face mouths. Vince McSkewerstun and Spanky Hardknucks. They were former members of the village. Neither of them are really aware of Denton Arthur's. The only thing that stands out to you of interest is Spanky Hardknucks notes that Denton can't resist using new technology and other elements that he gets access to. There's a little bit of mad scientist about him. So he takes everything, reworks it, uses it, has to try it. It's just who he is. And then they die, both of them.
Hmm. You have four brains now, Adam?
Let's say three. I ate one.
Okay.
There are three brains left. And the doctor deputy looks up at the rest of you and says, you know, you guys could probably use most of the robots, because in mine there was a lot of room. There's like a little thing, and then there's a whole thing shaped like the inside of a body. There's just kind of a gap.
Oh, so like disguise ourselves as robots for easier passage.
I mean, you could just use the body as like armor or whatever if you want to be protected.
Huh. Yeah. Hey, there's four of them here. Sure. I mean, I just got this. I'm going to put this down. I'll just use the four. I have my shield. It's a thing, but that's fine. Yes, I'm going to wear an armor. I don't know about you guys, but that's actually good job, Dr. Deputy.
No, thank you.
Okay.
No problem.
All right. Okay. I'm going to get in one of those suits then.
Mm-hmm. And I'm going to.
Del,
I'm
Tyler.
No. No. too terrible smell of dead body parts inside of robot. Not a fan. And B, I'm also just trying to keep track of the ghosts and where they wanted. So I'm super hyper focused on that now. Now that they're dead and they're not screaming.
The ghosts that were inside that body managed to travel up. Interestingly, all four of them went vertically upwards and disappeared. You get the feeling that you freed them by freeing them from this hellish mid-state between death and life.
That's nice.
Tyler, are you planning on pulling organs out of a robot to wear it as armor?
No, that feels like it would take too long. I think I've been basically just had my rifle up and trained on like the way we came just to make sure that no one's following us. I'm just waiting for us to move on. Yeah.
Great. So we'll make note now. New Rogue, can you roll me a con save? Shadow Nemesis, you don't have to because you're fine with corpses. So Shadow Nemesis, you just pull all the organs out of a robot and manage to slide on enough of it to function as armor. You get a breastplate. You get some covers for kind of your thighs, for the shoulders and the upper arms. Your AC will now be 13 plus your dex modifier.
That's me as well, 13?
That is you. So 13 plus your dex. So what's your dex right now?
Dexterity is plus one.
Great. So your AC is 14 right now.
14. Okay.
Del and Tyler, your AC will be 10 plus your dexterity, whatever that is. New Rogue, what did you roll?
Am I able to use advantage?
If you want to use an inspiration, time? Absolutely can.
Okay, I'll use inspiration. That was even worse. Okay. I was using my constitution. That's a nine.
It's a nine. All right. You take 1 point of damage as you throw up while you do this because it is incredibly gross. But you do haul the stuff out of the body and manage to make a cobble together kind of robot armor suit for yourself as well. Your head is free. Both of your heads are free. You're not wearing a helmet. It's not a robot costume. You had to deal with a lot of parts you couldn't fit your body into. But your AC will now be 13 plus your dexterity modifier as well.
13 plus dex. Okay.
Yeah. In terms of weapons, there were the two rifles and two flamethrowers in this room. Does everybody want to take a weapon?
I have a rifle.
Great. You got a rifle.
I'm not taking anything.
Del's taking nothing. Shadow Nemesis, you already had a flamethrower.
Yeah. Can I know I'm missing a hand, but like, can I, is there a way I can wear a second, like gas backpack, but kind of keep one like locked back in reserve in case I run out of juice in one?
You want like a reload tank? Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. All right. So I do that.
So you've got two canisters of the explosive fiery fuel on you, ready to flamethrower the world.
Oh, yeah.
And New Rogue.
I'll take the rifle. I have no quibbles. I'm just doing this.
Great. You've got the rifle. You've got the group is still with you. You've got Jack Magnum, the Nilbog, Rumple Foreskin, who is still fully in their barded armor because they just walked out from a battlefield. They're not limited. And Dr. Deputy in doll form carrying a steak knife. And that is when, Del, you feel a hand on your shoulder and the whole world goes hazy around you as you disappear for a brief moment. And you find yourself standing, looking at super goth Rihanna. Lucretia Sanguine has appeared before you.
Ooh.
And she says, I am so sorry about what happened on that battlefield. I couldn't quite hear you over the shrieking and the homicides and everything else.
Oh, I thought that was like a I'm sorry, like hit the bricks, like rejection. So I kind of took it that way.
Oh, no, no, darling. I would never push you away like that.
So So I say, I'm like trying to remember what I was trying to do here.
It seems like you've turned down the robots. You've turned down those weapons. Is there anything I can do for you? You know you're my favorite.
Right. I mean, I was kind of talking to ghosts. I mean, me and the ghosts were kind of doing a thing. I'm like bright red. I am also in my underwear.
Oh, no.
Oh, do you just a second. And she rests a hand on the strap of your tank top and it becomes whatever clothing, not armor, you want it to be. Whatever you would be comfortable talking in.
Okay. Then it's just like a... It's like a flowy page boy top and like black pants.
You feel those clothes grow out of the clothes you're wearing. And she's like, I want you to be the most comfortable you've ever been.
Oh, that's great. That's great. That's, I'm like, in my head, it's like slow motion. Because I'm like, I felt so sure when we were all about to die. And now I'm in a situation where I'm like trying to figure out what I should do here.
Do you know what? We can talk later. You're one hallway and one doorway away from a showdown with, you know, the Dark Lord you've been after this whole time.
Oh, really?
And you won't get a better chance than you do now. Most of the robots are broken, if they're even present. But I don't want you to be going into this entirely ill-equipped. So... let's try something a little different. For a kiss, I will give you some items that may prove useful.
Oh, it's not like a baby kiss.
No. Again, I'm not one of the tricky demons. That's not my thing. I don't mind the question. I just want to specify. All of my bargains will be very clearly laid out. We suck you by, though you may have heard.
And I'm going to interrupt her and put my hands on her chin and lean up and smooch this lady.
And you feel that moment of her being surprised and then kissing you back, and it is the perfect kind of kissing you want.
No.
I don't need Udell to reveal that on air. I just want to acknowledge that it's the perfect kind of kissing you
my
want.
Reaction was like me trying to be smooth and then that happening, be like, oh, come on.
And it lasts the perfect amount of time and it's the perfect amount of spicy, and then whoever you would prefer is the first one to withdraw. Again, we don't have to walk into that. But you find yourself staring at her afterwards.
And she says, I knew we were a pair. All right, so...
okay, we'll talk later. But yes, battle... okay,
I understand. That's why I have this for you.
And right, you did say that.
She flips a hand around, and you recognize a bag of holding. And you realize she has Adam's bag of holding in her hand. And she says, it turns out some magical items have such an impact in the universe, especially if they've been brought by the Watchers, that they kind of have their own souls.
Wow.
And having been owned or used by evil, they went to hell.
So I've brought them back for you, for your party to make use of. It's not everything, but it's most of it. Maybe it can help you. Maybe it can turn the tide.
Wow, that's great. Thank you. Well, thanks. Thanks for your help. And I'll take this
no
back.
No problem. She hands it to you and she says, I cannot wait to speak after this battle. Please, please survive for me.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
See you soon.
And she... taps you on the shoulder again, and you snap back into reality. Everybody, you see Del reappear, only now she is holding a lightly smoking version of Adam's bag of holding in her hands.
And I will almost robotically, because I'm like starstruck, walk this bag over to Adam, Shadow Nemesis. Here is it's your bag. Maybe there's weapons here. bag.
I black tears pour down my face, and I pick it up like a baby I haven't seen in months. And I just spin and I twirl like my things, my beautiful things are back. Ooh, and I open it up. I still have a list of stuff in my.
Oh, I was gonna say I've got here what you've got. So,
oh, okay.
Inside the bag, you find your magnetic cape.
All right,
your golden rat hat.
Yes.
The book, The Rats Came From Where? A how-to book for the rat hat.
Okay.
You find Dell's Ring of Negativity.
Ooh. Okay.
Your chew toy, the stone gargoyle brain with edible powder on it. The brooch of number numbing. Your nemesis axe. And Dr. Deputy's needle.
Ooh. Okay. So then I don't have... steak knife.
You do not find
two goblin daggers.
You do not find your scrap metal. There is no steak knife. The two goblin daggers are gone. There's no rotten finger goo. There's no doll dress. And your broken Black Knight helmet also is not there.
Oh, okay. All right. I'll just cross that out. Update. All right. I'll be like, all right, everybody. Who wants a... magnetic cape? No, nobody. Okay. How about
what?
Hey, who wants a nemesis axe?
But you don't?
Yeah, you probably do, huh?
Yeah, I thought this would be all you.
Well, I mean, give it back. But two flamethrowers is a little bit better than a nemesis axe right now. In fact, no, you're right. No, hold on. I'll keep it. And I'll put it on my hip and I'll be like, all right, what do we got?
What else is in there? She said there's probably something helpful.
Yes, there is something. Oh, I got that. Oh, I got a golden hat, got rat hat. I read the book a bit. We need cheese. Anybody got some cheese to make the hat work? No.
As you touch the hat, Shadow Nemesis, you realize that it is brimming with magic. Perhaps someone in hell fed it cheese, so it would be of use to you right now.
Oh, the hat works. The hat's full of rats. Okay, so who wants the rat hat? Nobody? All right, okay.
I'm shocked that you don't just want it.
Well, okay, look, we're in a bit of a pickle. I'm willing to share some things as long as they're given back.
I see.
So who wants a rat hat? If you want the axe, it's kind of, I haven't used it yet. Sometimes I get really cool items and I don't use them, but there's several like curses and things you can lay on people with this thing. So if you want it, you can have it.
What else? There's gotta be something actually useful.
Okay. Magnetic cape, golden rat hat, a book about the rat hat. I have my nemesis axe. Anybody? A steak knife. Oh, ooh, I got that ring that you used to have, Del. I have, ooh, I got this gargoyle brain that I sprinkle some of that powder on so I can chew. And my number numbing brooch. And that's
it. The one that makes you forget numbers.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that one. Yeah. We can use it on Denton. Ooh.
I was going to say that sounds like something, engineer would not like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's a good point.
All right. Mm-hmm. Who wants it?
I'll take that.
Yeah, put it on New Rogue. He's gonna look at New Rogue because New Rogue's the chosen one.
But okay, you can't. But I have to cover it up so that y'all don't look at it.
Okay, well, just hold on to it, and then when you meet Denton, run up to him and say like 1+1, and then he'll like freak out. And we can stab him.
Okay. So I bring my arm back inside the armor and I put it inside my thong. So yep, I'm loaded. I'm wondering, Del, when you popped away for a minute there, did Lucretia have anything else to say? Anything that might help us, or is it just the bag? Or
she just said, the bag might help us, but she did say that final battle is like two doorways away. So I guess we get to prepare ourselves.
Huh, okay. All right. Let's.
So we can take down Denton Arthur.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
If the cape's going back in the bag, I'll take the magnet cape.
Oh, there you go. Careful when you flick it. Because remember when I tried to do that and I tried to fly and it choked me? So it just like...
I just wad it up into a ball of fabric and just tuck it under my arm.
Oh, all right.
Rumpel Foreskin looks at all of you and says, okay, well, you got kind of the rest of us and we're a bit of a motley crew, but we could stay outside and... I don't know, prevent robots from randomly joining the battle on an ongoing basis. That might be a good way to help you.
That's extremely smart, Rumpelstiltskin.
Okay.
And Rumpel, it goes without saying, could you be a protector for little Jack Magnum?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. My plan is basically, Rumpel leans into you, I'm going to stand behind the Nilbog. It seems like they can't kill him.
Oh.
Good thinking, Rumpel.
Really good thinking.
All right. Well, if we've got a chosen one, do you want to do like a final speech before you face off with the big bad of the whole realm?
Sure. Everybody, do your best. Game faces.
Yeah.
Let's do it. And then I lock and load with the rifle. Do you cock a rifle? I've never used this before.
And that's the end of the episode right there.
That's the end of this episode, listener. But next week, you could become a watcher and affect the Jester's adventures by joining our Twitch stream, which happens every Wednesday night at 8:30 p.m. Eastern Time. That's Toronto time. If you join our Twitch chat, you can give the cast magical items, name NPCs, and decide the events that shape Ravenloft. So catch up on the story, follow Dum Dum Dice on Twitch, and join our weekly stream right away. Jesters of Ravenloft features the voices of players Tyler Hewitt, Del Borovic, Guy Bradford, and Adam McNamara, alongside Dungeon Master Ryan LaPlante. This episode was edited and mixed by Laura Hamstra, and Jesters of Ravenloft's artwork was created by Del Borovic at delborovic.com. That's D-E-L-B-O-R-O-V-I-C. Our theme song is Dark Mysterious Halloween Night by Sound Gallery by Dimitri Taras. And our ad breaks use the tracks No Control and Chiefs by Jazzar, J-A-H-Z-Z-A-R, whose music is available at freemusicarchive.org. For all things Dum Dums and Dice, including merchandise and how to join our Patreon, you can visit dumdumdice.com or find us on social media at dumdumdice. That's D-U-M-B-D-U-M-B-D-I-C-E. Now get out of here before the mist gets you too!
Dum Dums and Dice has to give a special thank you to the supreme beings of our Patreon at this time. Christopher Little, George Dolby, Richard Cranium, Gavin and Abby McDonald, Logan, Fire Unfriendly, Grandma Likes D&D, Alan, Stabby Stranger, Glitch Trick, Flynn1138, Alarain Okapi, Schrodinger's Pepper, Madre de Gatos, Lady Maiden, Garbo Ape, Locke, Sam Schaefer, Waffle Marine, Dagger Rain, Rob L, Dia Delos Hoodless, Squishy Werewolf, Remy, Funky Head, Nomad, the Wise Paladin of the Badlands, Accent Therapeutic Services in Florence, Kentucky, Lael, Shulzari, The Long Family, Jordan Oliver, Richard Wright, Brittany Fenwick, Alex Parr, Old Man Mojo, Dragonfly, The Body Barrelers, Megan Werner, A Man Out of Time, Curtis at FingerTechRobotics.com, Panda24NN, Shendra D, your homeboy Bones, the Gator Family, Ellis Hatch, Odigenous, Dan the Welshman, Afflicto Gaming, Aiden, and Jill and Noel LaPlante. If you want your name to be added to this list, you can join our Patreon too at patreon.com/dumdumdice. Thanks to them, and a little bit of thanks to you.